You can also say cinema peru prakatinchu. One more thing you need to remember. Yeah. You need to add andi honorific marker for all these imperatives if you want to show respect. For example, if you want to actually this andi is the honorific marker to show respect when you are talking with a single person, like to show elderly single person or in professional environment. Prakatinchandi cinema peru prakatinchandi. Prakatinchu is the imperative form, then andi prakatinchandi. But this, you know, this andi is used not only for single person, but when there are more than one person. For example, there is a group, there are four people, more than one. So for all the plural number of people, we must add andi. For example, tinandi, it means tinu. There are four people, you need to say tinandi. Okay,
tinandi.
Eat banana, arati pandu tinandi, because there are four people, you can say arati pandu tinandi. Let's see another example. There is only one person, he is like is younger than you. It's okay, you don't need to show respect. You can say arati pandu tinu in casual conversation, in as a friendly conversation, you can say arati pandu tinu. But when there are four people, you have to say arati pandu tinandi. Okay, andi you need to add for more people, for more than one people. And also andi is used even for singular to show respect or in any professional environment. But for casual things, for casual conversation, friendly conversations, no need to add andi. But elder, there is a senior person, if you want to show respect, arati pandu tinandi, it shows respect. So this is andi is very, it plays major role in speaking. Let's go to the next important verb. Okay, beautify means alankarinchu. Okay, okay, let's take this example. Beautify the room. Okay,
beautify, do you know the
do you know the meaning of room? If you don't know, I will tell you, then you make the sentence. There are few people, you need to tell them to beautify the room.
Room means kamra na,
but that is Hindi. In Telugu you can note down room means gadi.
Okay,
G-A-D-H-I.
Okay. Okay, so gadi alankarinchu.
Yes, correct. There are four people. If you want to say to four people, you need to say gadi alankarinchandi. You need to remember one more thing here. Said gadi. Gadi is like object, you know. This is like, you know, object position. So if you use any object, even in the previous sentence also, we need to add ni or nu suffix. This is very important. Gadi ni alankarinchandi. Yes. So you have to say gadi ni alankarinchandi. You can note down. Gadi ni alankarinchandi. It means beautify the room. We are going to have a shooting after some time. So you are telling them to gadi ni alankarinchandi. Beautify the room.
Me, I have to use everywhere. Means with every.
I will tell you. Actually, most of the times we have to use, but sometimes you can skip. It is okay. I will tell you the rule for this one. We use ni or nu suffix after the object. Okay, after the object.
Okay.
If the object is living thing like person or any animal, you must use. You should not skip. But if you are using a thing or any object or something like that, it is not necessary. You can skip the word ni or nu, But if you add, it gives like good good structure. In this case, you can also say gadi alankarinchandi, it is fine. Gadi alankarinchandi, it is fine. But as per the rule, we add ni or nu suffix in object position. The main rule is, if the object is living thing, we should not skip. You must add for any person if you use as an object. For example, I will tell you one more thing. Call him. Call him. Call ante pilugu.
Call means, sorry?
Call. C-A-L-L. Call. Call ante pilugu. Okay?
P-I?
P-I-L-U-V-U. Pilugu.
P-I-L-U?
V-U. Pilugu.
Okay.
Okay.
So, ye to pilugu ho gaya na?
V-U. V-U.
Pilugu. Okay, P-I-L-U-V-U.
Yes. Okay. Call. Okay. I'm giving another example. Call him. Him. Here, him is object. Okay. Him, okay. Men, him means atadi. Him ante atadi. Him means atadi. Then we must add ni suffix here. Atadi ni pilugu. Call him. Atadi ni pilugu. Oh. Ni is the suffix we must add because it is like living thing. Atadini pilugu, if you are telling to a single person, you can say atadini pilugu. And if you want to show respect and ask them to call, atadini pilavandi. In other case, when there are more people, when you are assigning the task, in that case also you can say atadini pilavandi. Okay?
Atadini pilavandi. Okay. So the call same way I can use that.
Ameni pilavu. Call her. Ameni pilavu or Amenu pilavandi. Okay, so we are discussing imperatives. Okay, so in this document, you will see only like single word, very single word. But while practicing, what you have to do, you have to expand the word with by adding additional words like what we discussed before. For example, call means pilavu. You need to add something else. Call him, call her, call them. So all those vocabulary knowledge you will get from the other videos. So yesterday I sent the link. You watch other videos also. Slowly you will build your vocabulary. Okay, you will build your vocabulary, and those additional words will help you in framing sentences. So initially you will learn in the first 38 videos, help you to structure the sentence or form the sentence, but that is not enough. Right. You need additional words to make sentences. Mm-hmm. So all those additional words are available in the coming lesson. So you continue watching, then practice simultaneously. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. We have a verb here. This is verb in base form. Also, it looks same in imperative form. Vanchu, for example, there is a stick. Okay, stick means karra. Okay, so you need to ask your friend to bend the stick. Okay, now can you try to translate? Bend this stick.
Bend this stick.
Stick, yeah. I will tell you the meanings per individual word. This means stick means karra. Now you frame the sentence.
Okay. Stick means karra.
Yes.
Okay. So karra vanchu or karra vanchundi?
Yes, both are correct. Yeah, depending on the situation, the person, you use andi or without andi. Then you need to add that demonstrative pronoun meaning. This means ye. Okay, bend this stick. Okay. So demonstrative pronoun will come at the beginning. Ye karra vanchu.
So this how to write in means in writing e, just e.
Okay, for the transliteration you can say e, like e, long vowel sound e.
Okay. So, e karra vanchu.
Yes. E karra vanchu in without respect, just casual conversation. But okay, there are more people there are, because if there are more people and if the and also if you want to show respect, you can say ee karra vanchandi.
Okay, and okay. What for that, this means e for this, and what for that?
Okay. Yeah, you write double okay. time. Okay.
Okay. So a karra vanchundi.
Yes, bend that stick. A karra vanchandi. Or a karra nu vanchandi. Again, you need to remember that nu is optional right. for non-living things.
Right.
Okay. So next, this is also very important verb. Bless. Bless means aashirvadinchu. Okay. For example, if you want to ask your parents to bless, okay, I will tell you English word, English phrase, you translate. Bless me. Okay, bless me. Me means, do you know already or can I tell you?
No, I don't know.
Okay, you can note down. Me means nannu.
Nannu.
Okay. Okay. Now you can frame the sentence.
Okay, so nannu aashirvadinchu.
Yeah.
Aashirvadinchundi.
Yes, you need to add andi because you are asking elders to bless. Uh-huh. So you must add andi suffix. So nannu aashirvadinchandi. That means nannu bless me. Yeah, bless okay. me. Yeah. There is another verb. Collect. Collect means sekarinchu. If you want to ask somebody to collect something, for example, collect some money. Okay. Now I will, since you are money. Beginner, I will tell you meaning for each word. Collect some yeah. money. Some ante konni. Money ante dabbulu.
Konni K-O-N-N.
Yeah. 1 minute. Okay, collect some money. Okay, so here collect means you can see the meaning here, sekarinchu. Okay, remember this one. You are going to make a sentence. Some means konni. Okay, money means dabbulu. Can you try to frame the sentence?
Dabbulu. Okay, collect some money. So sakrinchu konni dabbulu.
Yeah, the order is very important. Okay, order, how we put. Okay. Now in this sentence you will find the meaning. Okay, so the meaning, the order will be like this. Some money, it will be at the beginning. Okay, konni dabbulu sekarinchu. This is the order.
Okay.
Okay. So okay. you remember the imperative will be at the end. Imperative or verb, whatever is there, at the end. Okay. Always it will be at okay. the end. Before that, you need to add the additional words. Okay. Konni double sekarinchu, or you can also say konni double. Dabbu. Earlier I told you. We need to add nu or ni suffix after the object. Okay. okay. So here, dabbulu plus nu. Nu is the object. Becomes
okay.
like this. See? Dabbulu plus nu becomes, it will not, we don't say dabbulu nu. We say dabbulanu. Dabbulanu. So this nu becomes a sound when we add nu suffix. You see here? This is okay. dabbulu became dabbulanu. Konni dabbulanu. Yes. Konni dabbulanu sekarinchu. So you need to remember this lu is a plural marker. Dabbu is singular. Okay. Dabbulu is plural. In most cases, we make plural nouns by adding lu suffix. Okay. There is a lesson also in the coming coming topics, okay. you can watch those things. Okay, let's okay. go back to the original document. I will choose only the commonly used verbs, then we will discuss here. Okay, consult. Consult means sampradinchu. Okay, so let's, can you make a frame in, can you frame the sentence in English first, then try to translate? It should be in imperative form.
If I have to say consult with the doctor?
Yes, that will be in imperative form only. Yes, consult.
Consult with the doctor.
Yes, now try to translate. Doctor means you can say doctor only because it is most commonly used English word in Telugu also. But I will tell you the meaning just for learning purpose. Doctor means, but usually people don't say this one in Telugu. People say doctor only. Vaidyudini. Vaidyudu, then ni is the suffix. Okay. So vaidyudini or doctor nu.
Okay. Doctor nu. So, and
with means though, but here in this context, no need to use the meaning of though, meaning of with, I will write here, though. Because this nu is there, again, if you add though, it doesn't sound good. So no need to use that though, you can skip. Doctor nu sampradinchu or sampradinchandi.
Okay, fine.
Doctor nu sampradinchandi. Let's see the next important verb. Okay. Convince. Convince is also most commonly used verb. Okay. So let's say convince her. Okay, very simple sentence.
So
can you try? Yes.
Yeah. Amenu. For convince, what's the?
You can see there. It's there. I pasted here. Opinchu.
Opinchu or amenu opinchindi.
Yes, correct. Amenu opinchu or amenu opinchandi. Okay. Okay. Decide. Next verb, next commonly used verb is decide. Okay. Let's take decide as early as possible. This is one of the phrase which can be used in imperative form. Decide as early as possible because it's getting late. So you want to ask the people to decide as early as possible. So I will tell you the meaning of as early as possible. As early as possible means veelainanta twaraga.
It's too long.
Actually, all these meanings are explained in the other videos, but since you are beginning, I am telling again. Veelainanta twaraga. So whenever you have as early as possible, you just remember this meaning. Veelainanta twaraga. Can you try?
Veelainanta twaraga.
So you need to break like this. Yeah. Veelainanta. This is layi.
Okay.
Veelainanta twaraga. Veelainanta twaraga. Then you can bring this one. Nirnayinchu, but it is best to add andi suffix. So nirnayinchandi. Nirnayinchandi. Veelainanta twaraga nirnayinchandi. Decide as early as possible.
Okay. Veelainanta twaraga nirnayinchandi.
Nirnayinchandi, yes. Decorate, we already discussed the other one. Beautify. Beautify or decorate gives same meaning. Alankarinchu. Okay, describe. Let us see this one. Describe. Describe means varninchu. Can you tell me any example?
Describe, topic, describe this topic. ee topic lo varinchu.
Yes, describe this topic. Okay, topic means amsham.
Amsham, okay.
Okay, so I will write here amsham, then here I will write e. Okay, now frame the sentence.
Okay, so e amsham nu
exactly
describe e amsham nu varanchu
varninchu.
Okay, amsham nu varinchu.
You are missing na sound. Varninchu.
Varninchu.
Yes. Varninchu. Okay, let me write the meaning. E am sham nu. Am sham nu. Varninchu. Varninchu. Here no need I. Varninchu or varninchandi. Okay, let's go to the next word. Okay, divert. This is also commonly used meaning. Now we are making sentence like this. Okay, what you can do, you try Google Translator. Okay, do you use Google Translator?
No.
Okay, let me teach you. Let me teach you. Oh, wait. Okay, first, during your practice, since you don't know the meanings for all, you can take the dictionary help. In your homework time, you watch those videos and pass the video, take each imperative and try to make sentence like how we are doing now. For example, divert. Okay, divert is there. Just tell me any sentence using divert, but it should be in imperative form only. We cannot say, now we are not focusing on tenses. We are just asking someone to do something. That is the imperative. So you need to say like imperative sentence. Okay, tell me any example. For example, divert the traffic. Or divert his mind.
Yeah, divert his mind. So for mind, what I have to use?
Okay, now I will tell you how to use this translator. Sorry.
Mind.
Okay. Can you see the screen? I opened translate.google.com.
Uh-huh.
You never used this one? This is very popular.
No, I never used that. Is popular, but I never used actually.
Google Translate, you did not use? Okay. Let me send the link to you in WhatsApp. Okay. I sent the link. So you keep the source language English. Okay. Divert his mind. This is our practice sentence. Now go to Telugu language. Okay. So here you will find.
My one or two friends told me it's never come exact correct.
No, it will not come correctly. But since you are learning, you can use your knowledge to correct the sentences. Okay. See, here you need to see like this. This you cannot read, I think, because you are learning now. Right. But you see below, there is English transliteration.
Manasu.
Okay.
Manasu Mohachandiya.
Yes. Okay. And if you see here, again, what you can do, you bring this one, divert, put it here.
Okay.
Then below, this is the meaning for divert mallinchandi. Now you got up to some extent. Now type the word separately. Okay. First, you write the full sentence. Then try to write the individual word. So you will understand what's happening there. Okay. So his means, if you look at here, manasu mallinchandi is there. But in real life situations, we translate like this. We need to translate the word, translate the his meaning also. So his means tana or atadi, both are correct. So here I typed his, so I got tana. Okay, so tana you need to add at the beginning. Okay.
Okay.
Then mind. Mind means manasu. If you don't know, just copy this one and put it below. Then you will see the meaning in the next line. See? Actually, here it is showing. But here I need to click on show more. Okay. Manasu. Mind means manasu. Mind. Now you know the meaning for actually in my classes when I explain something like, you know, I explain many commonly used phrases, sentences. For example, there is a lengthy sentence. In all my lessons, I explained meaning for each phrase or word. If you understand meaning for each word or phrase, it is easy to understand and remember. So when you're translating, practicing also, you get the meaning for each word like this. You will see here. Then you need to frame the sentence. Manasu mallinchandi is there. So tana should be added at the beginning. Tana manasu mallinchandi. Okay?
Okay.
So tana manasu mallinchandi. You keep a word document and try to frame the sentences with the help of Google Translator. And the main verb you will find from our word document. For the additional words, take help from translator. There will be some mistakes, no problem, but you attempt. After a few weeks or days, you will have some experience in your mind. You will have some experience. No? So later you will not make mistakes.
Okay. So here I can use that Atadi Manasu also?
Yes, correct. Both are correct. Atadi Manasu Mallinchandi, divert his mind. For example, the boy is crying, okay? To stop his cry, you can say, Atadi Manasu Mallinchandi, give him a toy or anything, so he will stop crying. Atadi Manasu Mallinchandi.
Okay.
Okay, there is a sentence, earn. Okay. Can you try to make a sentence using the verb earn in imperative form?
Earn some respect.
Earn some respect. Okay. Now, let's go to the translator. I copied here. Okay. So, here I have Konta Gauram Sampadinchandi. See? Konta Gauram Sampadinchandi. If you are finding difficulty in reading this one, you can listen to the audio. There is a speaker button. I am pressing listen button.
Konta Gauravam Sampadinchandi.
Now did you hear?
Yeah, I can listen.
Okay. So konta means some. Okay. So here what you have to do in your practice, you need to break like this. Type like this.
Okay.
Type like this. Then click on show. You see the meaning. Earn sampadinchandi. In the same order, you need to look. Sam, konni, respect, gauram. So here you will see, here when I type sam, it is showing konni. But in the main translation, we have konta. So that is a problem. Okay. But at least you will get some knowledge from this. Okay.
Okay.
So remember this one, like, you know, konta is used a word like gauravam, like, you know, abstract nouns.
Okay.
For abstract nouns, if it is not countable, in those contexts you can use gauravam, but with practice you will understand when to use. The meaning of some is konta or konni. Okay. But with practice you will understand when to use konni, when to use kota. But for now you remember like abstract nouns. For that you can use konta. Okay, let me copy this one, or I will type there. Okay. Konta gauram sampadinchandi.
Okay. the respect. ये ऊपर डॉट डॉट क्यों आया है? Why it's coming dot?
In the translator, one minute. You mean here? It comes like that.
Okay.
Gauravam. Okay, okay. When we type, it will not come. But in Google Translator, it comes like that. Also, there is a line. You see, that yes, means you need to you need to pronounce as a long vowel sound. But you can ignore that dot because that will not make any difference. Gauravam, it's okay. But when you see the long that dash above the letter, you make it long vowel sound.
Okay.
Only that is important. But here above N also there is something symbol. But you remember that line above the vowel sound, only you need to make it long vowel sound. If you see any symbol above the consonant, just ignore it.
Okay.
Okay. See, this is sampa, sampa, dinchandi.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
That dash is a vowel.
Only focus the symbol which is above the vowel sound. Gauravam sampa. And you can ignore all the dots and other things. It will give confusion. Okay. But otherwise, just use this one. Listen. Then you will understand the pronunciation. Okay. I think that's all for today. We'll continue tomorrow. Practice like this.
Fine.
When you make more sentences, you will get doubts. Also, you will build your vocabulary. And when you have confidence with those words and all, you start using in your conversations with your friends.
Fine.